Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boys, Arcotics, bringing you another quick Battlefield 4 commentary here on Locker Domination with the M40. Real quick, we're going to talk about how to be a better aggressive sniper. Last week, I talked about how to be a better overall sniper and just to improve your overall sniping game. This is going to be focused more towards quick scoping and how to be a better aggressive sniper. So, real quick, let's get straight to it. First thing we're going to talk about is pre-aiming and drag scoping. So, those two pieces right there, you're definitely going to need to get good at. Pre-aiming basically means you're going to center your crosshairs over the target before you take the shot, and then obviously drag scope. When you're not on target all the time, you do need to move your scope over the target. So obviously what you need to do is practice on dragging your scope over the target using like the test range or just practicing in-game. Don't worry, you're not going to be amazing at it at first, because you, number one, you need to get down your sensitivity like I talked about last week, and number two, it just takes practice because you got to get used to moving targets. So but pre-aiming is a key piece of how to be aggressive sniper, because if you're having to always drag scope every single shot when you're not on target and you're zooming way off target, it's gonna take you very, very long to get those kills. So that's definitely one thing you're gonna want to work at. Now, jump strafing and pistol switching is the next. Jump strafing being a very key thing, especially since the netcode for Battlefield 4 is not very good. You're gonna need to learn how to basically jump strafe, which is basically when you jump and turn and look to the other side and jump out of the bullet fire after you take a shot. So if you watch in this video, I do a couple times. I jump after I take the shot because I don't want to get shot by someone who has an assault rifle or a PDW or LMG. Really, really helps with the fact that, you know, the net code isn't that good and it kind of takes you out of line of fire. And pistol switching as well is a great way to ensure you get those kills. So you're actually going to watch a pistol switch coming up right here. Bang, pistol switch. So I didn't know if I was going to get that kill or not. I didn't know if he was damaged or not, because with Battlefield 4, sometimes even when you get body shots straight to the chest, they don't die. And, you know, pistol switch does ensure that, because you'll be able to switch the pistol as soon as you take the shot and finish them off with a few bullets, especially if you hit them really, really close. Now, the last piece of that nice little topic is body shots. Now, body shots, you know, with most sniper rifles, except for the SR-338, which is a piece of shit gun anyway, you definitely don't want to use that. It's going to give you that one-hit kill, barring that enemy does not have the defensive perk. So within 12 and a half meters, you shoot them in the chest, they should die. Now, like I said, defensive perk and the net code sometimes can be a pain. But, you know, if you are spotting the enemy, if you, you know, have your index finger on the spot button, more than not, if you get that body shot or if you get a hit marker, you're going to be able to get your teammates to finish them off. Then you just get that assist counter skill, which is not as satisfying as getting the kill, but it does obviously give you those points, which is a really nice feature of Battlefield 4. So, and the last piece, and this is my final tip, is have fun while you're doing this. You know, it took me quite a while to get good at quick scoping in this game. You know, with the Xbox 360, I practiced, didn't do very good. Like, my KD was absolutely atrocious up until I got the Xbox One because of the 30 frames per second. And, you know, just being diligent on getting better and better and practicing and learning how to move around maps correctly and finding places where you can have better vantage points while you're learning to quickscope is going to make it fun. And obviously having fun is the main point. If you are doing this, if you're practicing learning how to quickscope and you're not having fun, you're doing it wrong. Because I truly get enjoyment out of Jelly smacking a kid real quick. He's got an assault rifle. I pop him right in the chest, and he's not even ready for that. And then he, you know, sends me a message basically saying I'm hacking or I'm cheating or whatever. And it makes me laugh. And if it doesn't do the same, it doesn't give you that same satisfaction. You shouldn't be sniping, especially not aggressively sniping, because that is why most of us do it. Is one, it takes too much skill, and two, it is a lot of fun, especially when it goes your way. But it's okay, though. Now, I will be posting a video on how to drag scope. I'm going to be showing people how I learn and kind of the quick steps on how to increase your accuracy when you drag scope. One of the biggest things is, like I said, learning a rifle. So what I talked about last week on learning a rifle, learning the way it zooms in is definitely a key thing. But like I said, learning that sensitivity to get a good ability to control and hit that body shot. It's going to give you those kills. So real quick, this is basically the end of the video. I ended the game 36-5. I straight up killed it. It was an awesome game with that nice little quad feed, five man on screen to start it out. So I will be posting more videos, more on that drag scoping later this week. Make sure you look out for that. Feel free to subscribe and also jelly smack that like button for more sniping vids. It's going to be awesome. It's been your boy Zarcotics. Peace out, y'all.